We invite you to take a multisensory journey, experiencing daily routines through a baby's eyes. Studies show that having a calming before bed routine can help babies fall asleep faster and sleep through the night better. Recommended routines include a warm bath, a soothing massage, and quiet time, such as a lullaby, reading, or talking about the day. Such routines provide ideal opportunities for parents to provide multisensorial stimulation for their babies. What's more, experiences that are repetitive, consistent, predictable, and nurturing can help promote the healthy development of a child's brain.
Hello, sweetie. Are you ready for your bath? Look who's here to help you with your bath. It's Ducky. Hey. Can you hear him splashing? Do you see the bubbles? Now they're gone. Oh, can you feel the water? It's nice and warm, but not too hot. Now, let's get you all clean. Now, let's get you all clean. Doesn't that smell great? Somebody really loves her bath.
The sense of smell is directly linked with memory and emotion. At birth, infants begin linking different smells with different objects, words, places, and people.
Buddy, do you want a bath too? I didn't think so. All done. Now, let's get you nice and clean. And then, you're gonna have a nice massage before bed. You love that, don't you? You love that. Okay, sweetie, do you want a massage? I'll take that as a yes. Now let's massage your feet, your legs, and those cute little toes.
In many ways, touch is our first language. An infant's first emotional bonds are built on physical contact. Routine massage can have benefits for both infant and caregiver. Infants who are touched display more eye contact, smiles, and vocalizations. In a study, infants who experienced routine touch and massage compared to those who did not were 50% more likely to make eye contact and 3 times more likely to have an overall positive expression.
Now for our finish. I love you. I love you. All done. Now, don't you feel good? And that massage was good for both you and me. You had a long day. A bath, a massage, and now it's sleepy time. But first, would you like me to read you a bedtime story? Yes? Remember the one with the wise old owl? Well, it's time for owl and rabbit to go to sleep too. Shh, 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 shh. It's okay. Mommy's gonna get the book now, okay?
Reading with your child and sharing thoughts about the day is a good way to wind down for sleep. Studies show that infants who are spoken with have larger vocabularies by 24 months.
And the wise old owl knew just what to say to the rabbit. And off they went to dreamland. Are you sleeping? Yes, you are.